Good evening. Thousands of furious Cross River Rail workers have walked off the job, marching through city streets and demanding better safety conditions at work.
The Transport Minister says a safety reset is underway and admits workers are right to be concerned after a 54-year-old man fell from scaffolding, leaving him fighting for life.
Marching down city streets.
I say Cross River, you say fire on Cross River! Cross River!
Walking off the job. Cross River Rail workers rallying in the Brisbane CBD as one of their colleagues, Nation Nash Cooker, lies on life support in hospital. The 54-year-old fell 10 metres from scaffolding at the Boggo Road site at lunchtime yesterday. He landed on cement. One of his workmates helped resuscitate. The reaction, swift and angry. Workers voting to down tools across all 13 Cross River Rail sites for the rest of the week, delivering a blunt message to the Cross River Rail Authority city office.
We're going to tell them what the workers' demands are. We're going to tell them how far we are to go until we get these demands met.
They want a better standard of safety. They're sick of being intimidated. They're sick of being bullied. They're sick of watching their workmates get hurt on the job. They're sick of watching their workmates get sacked every time they raise safety concerns.
There's no doubt that this is a wake-up call, and it's certainly shaken my confidence in terms of the safety on this project.
Workers say they'll be off the job until Monday. Among them, the 54-year-old son. Horrifically, he was working alongside his father here at the site yesterday when the fall occurred.
The union wants Mark Bailey to resign, saying it's raised safety concerns over Cross River Rail almost daily for years.
The injury rate, you know, per worker, per million hours worked on this is a lot lower than industry standards.
The CFMEU posted this video to social media in April. It was taken at the Roma Street Cross River Rail site, showing a worker on scaffold with no safety rail, no harness, centimetres from a large drop.
Time and time again, I've seen accidents, not just a splinter, life-threatening accidents.
Workplace Health and Safety is leading the investigation into Nash Cooker's fall. The Transport Minister says a safety reset is also underway.
Look, you know, if I was a worker on this project, I'd be concerned too. No doubt about that at all.
Somebody needs to be accountable. And if it's not the Minister, who is it?
Straight to Jessica Millwood now, who's at the Boggo Road site. Jess, a safety reset's one thing. Is the minister going to resign?
Evening, Andrew. Probably unsurprisingly, the minister says no, he won't be resigning. A safety audit was conducted of all scaffolding here at the Boggo Road site just a few weeks ago. Mark Bailey says it was given the tick of approval. All workers will come back on Monday, but they won't be back on the tools. They say that they'll be sitting inside offices until they are satisfied that a thorough workplace investigation has been carried out. So what all of this means for the future of this multi-billion dollar project, well, tonight that's very uncertain. As for Nash Cooker, he remains in a critical condition. His family are by his side. Alyssa. Yes, thank you for the update.